Welcome. My name is George Pearson, and I run the How to Gurus channel here on YouTube. Most of the videos in my channel are short demonstrations of the different tools and techniques you'll find in various software programs. Right now I have several hundred of these quick videos available on YouTube. This video, though, is different. This is part of a new series of longer demonstrations that I'm doing to show you how to complete complex projects from start to finish using a variety of techniques and tools. All of the images I use in these projects are in the public domain, and I've included a link to the pictures in the video description in case you want to work along using the same images. Okay, let's move on to the project. In this Photoshop photo repair video, we're going to improve a dramatically faded photo. And this one is really kind of all washed out. What we need to do is we need to bring in a lot more of the color back into the picture. Luckily, this is actually a very easy thing to do. It's a very, very fast technique. Here's our finished version. As you can see, this looks much, much better. It's much more like an actual photograph. And let's just see how we achieve this. Get rid of that. There we go. So here's our original. And we want to increase the coloration in here. So I'll take the background layer and drag this down to the new layer button. There's a new copy. Now we can blend these together and use one to multiply the colors in the other. So we'll use the multiply blending mode right there. Looking pretty good. We're getting closer. Let's do this again. Make another copy. There it is. Again, we are blending that down, and our colors are pretty rich now at this point. You can go further if you want to, and you know, take it even darker. That's up to you how far you want to take this technique. So that's pretty good. Now the last thing we need to do is to color balance the image. Obviously, you know, we're far too yellow in here. See, the teeth are real yellow, for instance. The background's real yellow. So we want to remove that yellow tint, and that's easy to do with an adjustment layer. So go up here to Layer, come down to New Adjustment Layer, and we want to work with our color balance. Bring that up. We're looking at the, you can look at our highlights and our midtones and our shadows. Let's start off with the highlights. There's too much yellow in the highlight. I'm going to try to bring that yellow down. I'm looking at the teeth primarily, trying to bring the yellow out of the teeth area. Maybe a little bit of the green out as well. Looking better. Let's look at our midtones now and see if we can pull out some of that yellow out of the midtones. And we're beginning to get better in there as well. And then finally we can take a look at the shadows, see if the shadows need anything. Probably not too much. The shadows look like they're okay. I'm just kind of, you know, rocking this back and forth to see what happens. And that's looking pretty good, as you can see. So, real fast technique, simply a matter of multiplying. Now I can bring in more color again by bringing in an additional layer. We're just multiplying all these layers together. Now once I brought in an additional layer, we have too much red happening in the shadow areas. We can fix that easily enough. Just double click here. Go back to our shadows, and let's just pull a little bit of that red out of the shadows, that magenta out of the shadows. Maybe not too much. And there we go. So from what was an image which looked almost unfixable, we really brought that up. Now you can take this further. I would probably come in here and do a little bit of an adjustment just on the teeth themselves. The teeth should go a lot whiter than that. But if I go too white on the teeth, it's going to mess up everything else. So what we need to do is to make a separate layer just for the teeth. I'll grab the polygonal lasso tool and let's zoom in a little bit here. We don't want to ever have these really stained looking teeth. So let's make a little selection here. And we'll bring the teeth out. I'm doing this real fast, but you probably want to take more time and do a more careful selection to make this really work out well. The better your selection, the tighter your selection is, the better the end result is going to be. That's always the case. So even though I do fast selections in these videos, when you're doing your selections, take your time and make your selections more careful. So let's go up here to Layer, New via Copy. There's our new layer. I'm going to move that above that adjustment and let's now do our separate adjustment on this one layer. And let's put that back to normal. See how bad the normal looks. You want to actually blend that in. And then we're going to give this an adjustment layer, or you can even, you know, go straight if you want to, right into your adjustments and color balance. So look at our highlights, and I want to pull the yellow out. And it's a bit of a, you know, kind of back and forth process, but that's getting a lot better in there. Let's see how we're doing. Yeah, that pulls a lot of that yellow out. And let's brighten those up just a little bit. Adjustments. Let's take a look at our brightness and contrast. Bring our contrast up just a bit and the brightness up a little bit. Looking better. We're still too much too yellow in there. I still want to remove some of that yellow tint. So let's just try color balance again. Let's check the midtones. No, nothing on that. Let's go back to our highlights again. Not really seeing anything any longer, any more effect on this. So let's come in here and try a little bit of a hue saturation. Sometimes this will work out. But if I bring the saturation down, we can get rid of some of the yellow tint. Now part of this, of course, is because we are multiplying this onto the other layers in behind. Pretty close. Let's just go through and check our different settings. I'm just going to use the wheel on my mouse and let's just scroll through and see if any of the different blending modes do anything better for us. That's actually not too bad. A soft light is not too bad. It's a little light on the gums. Real strange things happening in there. Vampire kind of stuff. Let's go back to the soft light. Which I think was pretty close. Okay, let's now fit this back on the screen. And there we go. A little bit of fine touching, you know, fine detail on the teeth as you saw there to get those just right. Let me bring that down just a bit. They're a bit too bright. And for all that work, that's better. That's blending in better. And there we go. So that's taking a dramatically faded photograph and bringing it back so we have a real nice photo again. Let's just take out all of these adjustments. You can see there is the original. Massively faded and really going over to the yellows and then bring back in all of our adjustments and there we go, a repaired photograph. Thank you for watching this special Photoshop photography project video. Don't forget to subscribe so that you will get first notice of new project videos in the future. Just click on this link right here where it says subscribe here. You can get all 12 project videos in this series, along with 26 special videos demonstrating the tools and techniques that I used in these projects by clicking on this link right down here. And then thank you again for watching this training video.